What's up, everyone? We're back with the Cubase Pro 9. So it just came out, and I know that everyone and their brother are doing videos on this. But despite that, I think I'll do one as well. The big thing that everyone's pooping their pants about is this lower zone. You get the mix console, the editor, the sampler, which is kind of cool. So I have this thing in here. It's just a sample. And you can warp it. And use glide and stuff like that. So yeah, it's a simple sampler, but I'm sure that it'll be handy to have. Just when you don't want to open up Kontakt or Groove Agent or something like that, you can just toss it into the lower zone. But as for the lower zone, I will not use it. Control Alt E gets rid of it, and I would prefer to have big ass mix console on my second screen. But for those of you working on laptops, I'm sure that it'll be a welcome addition. So the other thing you get are extra plugins. I don't have any of them on this project. Just you get a new EQ, and you get a new maximizer and a new looking compressor, and I'm sure they're fine. You get mix console history. So if we bring back my mixer, this is what I've done on this project. But I don't think that it saves, persists between sessions. So you might want to make sure that you have everything the way you want it before you close the session, or else you'd be in a world of hurt. So one thing that jarred me when I first got this is that the default key editor colors are the project colors, and it's all blasted out, and the contrast sucks, and I couldn't tell what was going on. So I quickly fixed that by going into File, Preferences, Editors, Use Project Colors, unclick that, and you get the old-fashioned purple and red on a white background, which looks better to my eyes. So if you all are interested in doing it, again, that's Preferences, Colors, General Editors, and then unclick Used Project Colors. So that was nice. As far as everything else, it's running okay. I think it might be eating a little bit more CPU than 8.5 was, but that may just be some specific quirk of my hardware, and I'm sure that they're going to iron out all the kinks as further updates come out to Cubase 9.0. One thing that I really do like is having this transport bar down here at the bottom instead of this floating transport window that we all came to know and not necessarily love in previous versions of Cubase, because it always got in my way. I had no idea where to put it. Do I put it up here? Then I can't see my tools. Do I put it in the mix console? Then it gets in the way when I'm trying to mix. So it's nice to have a dedicated transport bar. And as far as everything else is concerned, I mean, it's a new version of Cubase, and it's great, I suppose. I mean, it seems like all the others, and it seems like it's working just fine. And yeah. So if you're interested in checking it out, you can get it at the link in the description, or you probably already have it if you're watching this video. So keep making music, everyone, and have a good day. Bye.